I heard a rumor.
Fuck a T-Rex.
Buy toilet paper.
Farts in an elevator.
I ate shit on the first day.
The scene where Luther farts in an elevator that we're all stuck in.
The elevator.
Oh, there's so
scene.
Many. Oh.
Up to the tiki bar always sticks in my head. I mean, I don't actually think we got a clean take with David Castaneda.
No. But if you see the take that they used, everyone's acting like it smells. I'm just like laughing.
Luther.
Oh God.
Sorry, I'm nervous.
I also remember that scene with you, Tom, where asking you questions.
Oh my God, yeah.
I ask something about like how I caused the apocalypse and how you go, well, you blew up the moon. And like,
I couldn't say it seriously.
Where I feel like it took us a while to get that.
What caused the apocalypse?
Lost control and you blew up the moon.
My favorite memory of Robert Sheehan on set was when he had this huge vomit rig attached to him. And finally, we're rolling, and he opens his mouth, and nothing comes. It was like two little squirts of...
And it sort of came out from like there.
I ate shit on the first day. I like slid across that gravel driveway so hard. I still have like scars all up my leg. It was pretty rough.
Oh my God. That was a bad fall. And I pulled my hamstring because they're...
Yeah, you did. Running in the snow.
In the snow. Yeah, because my shoes were so incredibly slippy. It was unbelievable. I started sprinting and my foot went behind me and I just heard my hamstring twang.
We were throwing hands out in the country road.
It was really hot that day. We were just sweating buckets on top of each other on that burning hot pavement.
I heard a rumor.
Man.
Really?
Yeah, I got in trouble the other day.
Yeah, like David would say, yeah, well, Steve told me this. And I'm like, did he really? Or did he say something that was like that and you've made it into that?
I would definitely say David, because a couple of weeks ago, he prematurely released our poster online. I don't know if you know this, Robbie. It was hilarious.
Yeah, I was like, hey, like they put a new photo up. That's cool. Took a photo of it, put it online. I'm in London, so I let my phone down and then like notice I have like four voicemails, two messages, two emails, a few phone calls, and it's all of them. Can you take that down, please? Take it down. And I was like, oops.
That's such a big
crime. I know.
If you could just like pop back and like look at dinosaurs, that'd be pretty cool, you know? Go and be like, oh, fuck a T-Rex, and then...
Yeah.
Yeah, just in time.
Start running.
Oh shit, I've got a minute 55 to survive.
Yeah, what's my briefcase?
I'd go back to the 70s, start a rock band.
Season one was pretty good. I had a great time that year. My God, it was just... Brilliant.
I would actually go back last year and say a virus is coming. Buy toilet paper.
Well, let's go dead, because that's dead is always more fun. Dead, I'd probably go Bowie. He'd be a really interesting dinner guest. But alive, I'd likely go with John Mayer.
I want to hang out with JTT, maybe. No?
Yeah.
Yeah.
From
like my childhood crush, secretly I just wanted to be him and like look like him, you know.
Yeah, I would love to have dinner with the Spice Girls. I would love to have dinner with the Spice Girls.
Oh, for the Friends cast, I want to have dinner with.
Yeah, see, it's like the options are endless. So
okay. Yeah,
Alan Watts and Muhammad Ali, that'd be a nice little dinner party.
Anyone at this point, because I've just been alone.
We play charades a lot. A lot of people read. We've got a lot of... Justin's a big reader. I'm a big reader. Ellen's a big reader.
I'm audiobooks.
Sometimes it's a very boring day on set. You go over to the cast area and we're all just have our noses in the books.
Like that. I'm just stood there staring, listening.
And we played Scrabble. Robert hustled me. he made it seem like he had never played before. And just like, oh, I don't really know what I'm doing. And then suddenly it's like quadruple word score with the letter Q, 500 points.
I love how loyal she is and how nurturing she is and how independent she is.
I like her resilience, I feel like, because she's been through a lot. In the second season, it's nice because we do see someone who's happier and able to connect to their emotions and falls in love for the first time.
I think I love how he, no matter what decision he makes, Luther desperately wants to do the right thing. So he's deeply caring, actually.
I like Five's chaos. Whenever I get to play that side of him, it's really fun. Challenging, but it's fun.